All right, what's up everyone? This is Blockchain News Korea with a slightly different concept today. Well, let's call it the crypto debate. So we're going to give you one piece of news and we'd like to hear your comments on which side of the debate that you guys fall under. Today's May 24th here in Seoul, Korea. And the news is Bitcoin price has hypothetical value of $1,800 according to a Federal Reserve report from the United States. The Federal Reserve Bank of San Francisco released a report on May 18th discussing the volatility of the Bitcoin price and its impact on the ways Bitcoin should be classified, whether it should be a currency, security, or commodity. The author of the publication and fintech policy advisor at the Federal Reserve's San Francisco branch confirms what many have already said, that Bitcoin straddles the properties of all three asset classes. However, he draws interesting points over properties that make Bitcoin fit into one category better over others. He also shows historical evidence that suggests Bitcoin is in a bubble without saying firmly whether it is or not. The price volatility would be an obvious reason why Bitcoin struggles as a real-world currency. And he looks more closely at ways it is currently used in the marketplace alongside central banking structures. His conclusion comes as no surprise. Bitcoin is not traded for goods much at all, in addition to increasingly unfavorable global regulations. He says that Bitcoin lacks a corresponding real value, which is a key part in exchange for goods. When looking at the Bitcoin exchange rate, this category of determinants seems to be inapplicable. There is no current native Bitcoin economy with no native Bitcoin prices for goods and services. As a security, Bitcoin fares better in the current framework, though not great. Securities are either purchases of debt or stakes in a company, and it doesn't fit into either of these categories since it does not generate a consistent interest, dividends, or capital gains. Last but not least, as a commodity and often mentioned store of value, however, Bitcoin behaves much like entrenched commodities like gold and oil. Though he argues that Bitcoin lacks intrinsic value, he points to mining as the key form of placing value on the asset, a value he says that approximates to roughly $1,800 per coin. This hypothetical value of $1,800 is far lower than Bitcoin's current price. And he only strikes the bubble fear home with a look at the stages of Bitcoin's FOMO and euphoria cycles that pattern previous bubbles in the marketplace. So let's look at CoinMarketCap's Bitcoin's price, which is currently at around $7,600, which is a drop of about 4% from yesterday. Looking at this sort of curve in prices, where do you guys fall on this debate? Do you think it is a currency, a security, or a commodity? Do you think that Bitcoin is good for being used as a currency to purchase goods and to receive payment for goods? Do you think it's a security that you can expect to receive capital gains or interest or dividend from it? Or is it more like a commodity like gold, oil, wheat? In that it doesn't really generate any value, but it can be used as a store of value and can be traded like a commodity. Some people think that Bitcoin's adoption curve will sort of run like this and it'll continue to rise, and we've sort of started that rise starting from last year. Or do you think that the price will peter out? Do you think that this sort of dip is sort of a brief dip, although we've had this correction for several months now? We'd like to hear on what you think the future price will be and where you fall on this sort of debate. Do you agree with the Federal Reserve's report or not? Just any sort of comments that you may have on this, we'd like to hear your comments. So yeah, this is not sort of any advice. This is just sort of to get you guys to comment and hear what you guys have to think about this. So please leave your comments below, hit subscribe. And if you have any sort of ideas for future topics you'd like to debate on, please leave them in the comments section below. All right, so have a nice day, and we'll speak to you tomorrow. See you.